What up?
It's the Trooper. Yo, it's like 9:45 in the morning. It is Tuesday. Yeah. Trooper, you got some pineapple cream cheese turnover action going? How you guess? You damn right I do. Trooper, what the hell you doing up so early? I mean, it's 10:29 in the a.m. I'm definitely not usually awake at this point. Surprisingly, I got up feeling not tired and ready to go. I guess in the spirit of the World Series of Poker and all this poker tournament action going on around town, decided to get into a poker tournament today. What? Trooper? Tournament time? Tournament time. AM. Tournament starts at 11, just enough time to hit Starbucks. Maybe. I don't like to miss hands. Cutting it awfully close. But they moved a lot faster than I expected. All right, it's the $400 tournament today. I think it's 40K guarantee. Who knows? Got some poker tournament action going. First of all, let me just inform you that this $400 tournament at Aria is fast as shit. You start with 25,000 chips, and the first blinds were 100, 200, which already is an indicator that this is not going to be a slow tournament. Then it went 100, 200, 200 ante, and then it went 200, 400, these are 30 minute levels, 2-4 with 400 ante, and then level 4 was 3-5 with a 500 ante. So, starting at an hour and a half into the game, it's cost 1,300, well, 1 hour into the game, it's costing 1,000 chips per round, and an hour and a half into the game, it's costing 1,300 chips per orbit, per player. You start with 25,000 chips. It's a fast tournament. We're going back to 3-6-6 right now. Unfortunately, over the last hour, every single time I put a chip in the pot, someone shoves all in or whatever. I have 12,500 chips at the moment. Still okay, but I won't be okay for long. I'm either gonna have to pick up some chips or, you know, it ain't gonna go too good. the second break, a 20-minute break. We have played 8 levels now, and we've managed to turn it around a little bit. How many chips did I have at last break? 14,000. I now have 67,500 chips. We're going back to, I don't even know, it was 6-12 and 12 just now. Getting rid of the $100 chips, I guess it's gonna be it's probably gonna be 1,000, 15, 15. That's just a guess. They did do 3-5-5 earlier, because we're getting rid of the blacks and it was just 1,200. It's not gonna jump to 2,000, is it? That's poker. What? You know what that means. It was level 12. Early in level 12, the blinds were 1,500, 3,000, 3,000 ante from the big blind. So the big blind has to put in 6,000. The small blind puts in 1,500. I had about 76,000 chips. At my highest point, I had 101,000. That's the biggest stack I run up for the whole day. There were 72, I believe, remaining. 35 got paid. 271 started. I was in seat 2. Guy on my right in seat 1. Seems solid. He came in late. But I watched him open the button with 10-4 offsuit. He was opening a lot. So it folded around to him, and he made it 6,000. I've got 1,500 in for the small blind. It's 15,000, remember. So he made it 6,000, and I had pocket eights in the small blind, so I re-raised to 21,000. He went all in, and of course, I called, and he had pocket nines. And that will do it for the poker tournament for the day.
Caesar. I appreciate it.
No, it takes a lot. Yeah, no.
Thank you for the lollipops. Thank you for the hat.
Yeah.
I don't know. Bye.
That's it. That's it. Oh, no. No, you didn't.
Anyways, before you go,
pop down.
Okay, perfect.
Sean.
Oh, gosh. Are we on?
Sean and Rose. Sean and Rose.
Hello.
From Texas again.
Hello.
Special gift.
Thanks for getting the pops.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you for bringing them. My daughter is going to appreciate them.
Oh, good.
Thanks for the new hat.
Oh, new hat action.
Yes.
Shout out to our daughter, still in Texas, for a niece. We love you, niece. Sorry you didn't get to come this time.
Yes.
And it's my 50th birthday today.
Oh, that's right. Happy birthday.
Birthday.
Happy birthday. I forgot about that. So now it's kind of weird. It's 5:30 in the afternoon. I just played poker for 6 hours. That's kind of weird, 5:30 in the afternoon. You know what I mean? Usually I quit playing poker around midnight or something. So what do you do? I mean, I'm feeling a little bit tired, to be honest, because I woke up at 8 o'clock sharp, hit the floor running at 8 a.m., which is about 4 hours earlier than I normally do. But I haven't really eaten food yet today. All I've had is baked goods because there was no time for anything else. So what do? Do you get Posh Burger or do you go home and eat something maybe slightly more healthy? But I mean, come on, what's more healthy than a Posh Burger? I do have some thoughts after playing the tournament today though. Firstly, I always knew there was a reason why I take an extra long shower when I get home from a poker room, and why I wash my phone. I came back from one of the breaks, and this dude, I looked over my shoulder and I saw that he had Posh Burger. He had the bag sitting beside him or whatever. but I watched him take a paper napkin from Posh Burger, put it up to his nose, blow his nose, wipe his nose, and without folding, crumpling, let alone changing the napkin, he brought it directly from his nostrils down to his mouth. Wiped his entire mouth, including inside his lips. Now I know what you're thinking, Trooper. Trooper, how do you see that in that much detail? Believe me, I was mesmerized. I couldn't take my eyes off of it. All I could focus on was where he was putting that snotty napkin. While we're at it, I have another thought. I know what you're thinking, Trooper. Save some of these thoughts for another vlog. One day when you don't have a story to tell. You know, I'm not very good at that. This is fresh on my mind. One of the most annoying things that I see in a poker room, and by the way, there are many. But one of the most annoying things is when someone continuously asks for change, for chips, larger denomination chips, when they don't need it. There are a staggering number of tournament poker players who are obsessed with making change, both being the bank and trying to force other people to be the bank. One such player was at my table today, and she just was constantly asking the lady to my left to break the 5K chips when she didn't need any change. She had like a stack of 1K chips, a stack of 500 chips, and then one time she asked me to break it. But I don't want to be rude, but I should be like, no, clearly that chip is unlucky because why do you want to break it? Even if I need change, I don't need change because the dealer will make change. I never ask another player for change, ever. Why would I want to annoy someone with something that's unnecessary, right? So that lady today, she kept asking everyone to break, not everyone, the lady to my left and me, to break her 5K chips because she wanted more chips in her stack, not because she needed them. That is super annoying. Here's how I feel. I feel like it's intrusive to put someone in a position where they likely want to say no, but they don't want to, but they might not want to feel rude or whatever. Like, it's like, why would I want to put someone in a position where I know they want to say no? And maybe they have to say no. Maybe we're not even talking about change anymore. Could you imagine asking someone something where the answer should be no, but you ask them anyway? It's intrusive. You're putting the person in an awkward position where they have to say no. You know what I mean? Like, it's just weird. I don't know. I think I want to play this weekend. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday would be day 1A, day 1B, and day 1C for a $600 buy-in, $250,000 guarantee at the Venetian. Day 2 is on Monday. So we're talking about a pretty decent-sized tournament here, a two-day situation. I feel like playing that. As far as tonight goes, go home, take a shower, frozen pizza, edit the vlog, maybe play online cash game until I'm like this. Bam! Face hits the keyboard. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.